Hello, so I'm just a regular gamer, but I mostly play better games, to be honest. And I don't really care about graphics or stuff like that, but this game was intriguing to me because from the trailers you look spotless, you look like game of the year material. But then when people started to play it, they noticed a little problem. And the little problem became bigger and bigger and bigger and it blew up. But what about the scores and the reviews? It's still positive 94%. But there is a little catchphrase in here, so yeah, this is why this video is called Unpopular Opinions. And I basically watched the entire game in a day off YouTube, so yeah. For starters, let's see what this is really like. I mean, the trailer will make you believe it's something really good and it's interesting and the story is different. But to be honest, it can all be summed up with one picture. What have they done with the game? It had massive potential, and then many people say that halfway through the game loses its steam. And yeah, the biggest problem with the game, in my opinion, is the completion time. Oh, and believe me, I have some dates for that. Dates, or numbers, or data. Commenter data, yeah. So again, this is not really telling us much because not a lot of people actually played it so far. But this is representative of the times. Look at this. 9 hours to play the main story, 11 hours to play the main story and do everything else. Completionist, 14 hours. All play styles, 9 hours. So this is basically telling us that people took in average about 12 hours to finish the game. I think the playtime is around, again, 10 hours, 9 hours, or let's say 10 to 11 hours in total. And it's a 45 € game. Are people insane, or what is happening here? But if you want to read more about it, we'll have to check out the Steam. Because you know, if you buy a game on Steam, that means two things. You like the game, and you want to play the game, and possibly you want to finish the game. So that's why I think that reviews on Steam, if they're below, let's say, 70%, the game is bad. The game can be very bad. There are a lot of exceptions though, so again, this one has 94 positive reviews. But if you read the first review, you'll see that something is very wrong. In this day in age of gaming, it's all about the open world sandboxes and 100 plus hours you can plug into a game. But yeah, that's the standard, right? So no, the standard now is 10 hours of gameplay. Again, let's read some of the reviews that are, well, let's say, highly rated on Steam. Again, these people bought the game because they like the game, they saw it from the trailers. I mean, everyone watches game trailers and possibly even someone played before they buy it right now. So it's not saying they bought it without knowing what it is. But I think that's a rare case today. So let's see. I guess you can look at this in a different way. So again, it's not for kids. The difficulty is easy. But again, the reviews are mostly positive, and what they are saying is that it's a breath of fresh air or something like that. But if you look closely, gameplay boring, it reminds me of The Last of Us. Again, this is calling out to other games. It's worth. There should be more DLC. Again, you will pay $100 for a game that you play for 20 hours, let's say. Is that a good suggestion? I don't know, I don't like it. The story is incredible. No, it's not incredible. I'll speak about the story without spoilers. The price is too much for the amount of time it takes to beat the game. So yeah, this person bought the game and the review is positive. 8 hours, I think he finished the game already and left the game alone. 30 people think this is helpful. Yeah, it's not worth the price. I mean, that's the whole thing. It's not worth the price. For a game of this length and this gameplay mechanics, I think the price should be about 50% off. And they should add DLC. Yeah, they should definitely lower the base price and add DLC if they want it to be fair at least. I mean, look at this one. This is a fun older sis simulator. Yeah, and you get pushed into the rats and die. But this, you get hit, you get one hit, you die from the rats. 10 times in 8 hours. Again, 8 hours of playtime. So, if you want to see an average, I think the average is lower than 10 hours if you compare all these hours. There are people who played more, there are people who didn't finish the game after the review. But what I found most interesting about this is reading the negative reviews. Let's say the most helpful one. Hostile of loot boxes, DRM, battle royales and microtransactions. Rats. Again, these people finished the game already. That's the problem with it. It's not really worth the price. And it's about rats, and they don't really speak about the bad stuff, but they post a positive review and they speak about it's good, but it's not worth it or something like that. That's how the review sounds like. So yeah, let's go back to the reviews. And this time let's read the negative reviews, because that's the problem with the game. And people just refuse to acknowledge the problems. So again, the negative reviews, almost all of them have better rating from other people. As you can see, I have not rated any of them. 100 people, 200, 300. Again, this is a new game fairly. So I think the reviews may change and the rating may change as well. Cons. Story went from interesting to bad. Yeah, halfway the story gets bad. Plot twists are obvious. The little brother deserves to die. I agree with that. The stealth is very basic. I mean, it's bare bones. AI is bad. One hit kills you mechanic becomes very frustrating. Spoiler. Yeah, that's a little spoiler. If you read that, no Tori. They made a pre-order DLC and limited to some resellers only, but without forcing other resellers to state they weren't part of the offer. Yeah, because they made a pre-order DLC and okay, that's a very shady practice right there, and this is where I'm going to. The story is intricate, the atmosphere is great, the atmosphere is definitely great, the AI is bad. So you have a lot of save spots, and basically you can, even if you die 100 times in one spot, you can still finish the game in, let's say, 10 to 11 hours, because the save spots are really put right there where you need them. Let's say, performance-wise, I don't want to talk about it, it's about your PC sometimes. Yeah. I mentioned this as many people won't be satisfied with 8 to 10 hours for $45. With the best... Come on. There is no challenges. Again, that's another problem. And I'm reading this because I don't want people to think I'm a hater or... I'm a little hater. But at the same time, I just want a better gaming foundation for everyone. So if people continue to buy these games with nothing innovative, just the graphics, they'll keep coming. And studios like these ones, well, instead of making a better game with better mechanics, we'll just make something like a cutscene movie or a movie simulator. And as you know it, the big studios are mostly buying the smaller studios, which actually make good games, and they'll force them to make commercial games. So this is the highest. Oh no, let's say this in a different way. This is the highest form of a commercial game that I have ever seen this year, or actually in my entire life. The game is not so bad, but it's not so good. It's not worth the price, and they have some shady practices. Again, you are fighting rats and knights. And because, well, it's almost the apocalypse, people are killing each other, and the Inquisition is the bad guy. The Inquisition is always the bad guy, and they're killing children and so on. But you will kill also the Inquisition, which makes you also a killer. And you are a 15-year-old girl, so you are killing rats and people at 15 years old, just to save your brother who... Anyway, the story is complicated, but not complex. as you know, that guy from Apex Legend would say. Again, it's mostly talking about, there's nothing inherently bad, so this one actually details everything a lot better. It's not inherently bad about the game. There is not anything good about it either. It's a bland mix of boring mechanics and interesting characters. So this is a commercial game. A bland mix of boring mechanics and uninteresting characters with a great atmosphere and good graphics. Alt theme around the main plot with a bunch of themes that are hinted and unexplored. Again, yeah, nothing is really explored in the game. The story feels like every chapter was written by someone else, true, with something possibly interesting to explore only to be ignored for the remainder of the game. Exactly. The gameplay mechanics work, but they're just meh, and yeah, there is crafting. So again, in my opinion, the game is not worth it, but if you decide to buy it, it will be a good experience because it has a lot of effort put into it and a lot of money, as you can see from the little trailer right here. But those are basically all the mechanics, and again, it's too short. Why would people pay almost full price for a game that short? I mean, I'm playing Outward right now. This is the DLC that people are talking about. Coat of Arms. That was a funny one. I'm playing Outward and it almost has the same price as this game and I have almost 150 hours into the game. Yeah, not everyone wants to spend 100 hours in the game, but at the same time, what is happening to gaming right now? Because people are starting to lose their minds over games like this one. I'm sure I'll get a lot of negative responses and negative comments and dislikes and stuff like that, but at least I made you think about this one. Bye.